What's up, everybody? Welcome to beautiful Gangjin Jeollado, where I'll be here for the next 3 days introducing to you a place I'm sure you've never heard of because they don't have the budget to throw Olympics or have a bunch of K-pop TikTokers come out here and dance to BTS filming locations. But I'm here to show you why this is the real Korea that you need to come to before it disappears. Now, this is where I'm gonna have to warn you that this isn't gonna be a typical travel vlog where I hype up the tourist facilities or the cuisine, but it's gonna be a personal story because to me, Jeollado is my grandfather.
Where did you go?
Ah, I'm going to go. Ah, I'm going to go. That's why it's Jeollado. Yes. Jeollado is the reason
why it's Now, the first thing I want to tell you about my grandfather and Jeollado is that he was a very friendly man. He would not pass up an opportunity to strike up a conversation with a stranger or give him any kind of advice or tips. Now, the reason why I think that that is probably the most important aspect of Jeollado is when I started talking about my grandfather and Jeollado and my experiences here, you'll find that there's a lot of things that may seem like it's contradicting itself, that doesn't flow with our logic of how things are. It's not something that's easy to grasp initially, but because I sincerely feel that the people here want to teach me and help me understand the complexities and the uniqueness of this province. Just how easily approachable the people are here. I mean, as a matter of fact, they'll just approach you. You don't even need to approach them. I think that is one of the main assets of Jeollado. And the reason why I love my grandfather and this province so much. Now, the other thing that you have to know about Jeollado is that everything is sort of at a slower pace here. But that doesn't correctly describe how Jeollado is, because Jeollado also isn't lazy. The people of Jeollado and my grandfather are one of the most industrious people. Because this is an agricultural place, things have a rhythm to it and people have to be working. But why do I think it's slow pace? I think it might be because the people of Jeollado are also proud. If you put it in a bad way, maybe they're stubborn. But at the same time, this is a great thing because the people of Jeollado and my grandfather, they're one of the most understanding people. So when everybody is somewhat proud of what they are and somewhat set in their ways, and they're also respectful at the same time, an American like me, where I have my own way of thinking, own way of doing things, I find it relatively easy out here because they let me take my time and slow down if I need to and do things. And if I ask them to slow down as well to explain things to me, they do that as well. So this is one of the reasons why I think Jeollado is not only approachable, but very relaxing and easy to travel and maybe even live in.
안녕하세요.
멀어요?
네, 멀어요.
By the way, guys, I forgot the name of this place, but I'm at one of the top 10 walking trails here in Korea, and it's right here in Gangjin. I love the fact that I can take it slow and take it on my own pace. 안녕하세요. 네. Now, this brings me to another interesting characteristic of my grandfather, and it's that he cared a lot about how things looked. It doesn't matter if you are nice, understanding, respectful. He wouldn't have liked it if it wasn't aesthetically beautiful, but I can appreciate how he loved things beautiful, because look how magnificent Jeollado is. Now this is where, for the longest time, I underrated Jeollado. And that's probably my American self projecting what I know of America. Let's not kid ourselves. People in the countryside don't really care about aesthetics. They're sort of, you know, farmers or just hardworking people. They pride themselves in not being aesthetically pleasing. That's a characteristic of an American. We could dress up nice, but we dressed up in sort of crappy clothes just to say we can, and, you know, instead of driving a Mercedes, we will choose to drive a pickup truck because that rough and tough attitude sort of, I don't know, appeals to people. But just because this is a countryside doesn't mean the people here don't care about the aesthetics of things. If you understand the history of Korea, you would know that Jeollado once was probably the most prosperous area of Korea, because not only until recently has Korea actually industrialized, and up to that point, Jeollado and areas like Gangjin here were historically the most fertile land where you could grow and produce rice, which used to be Korea's biggest export. So when you have a combination of a very historically prosperous and rich region together with people who pride themselves in holding on to their cultural heritage and what makes them unique about Jeollado, you end up with an abundance of very well-maintained historical sites and beautifully cultivated landscape. I mean, even just look at the rice fields. Everything is just so organized and laid out in perfect little squares. I sometimes find myself flying my drone and filming myself driving through these rice fields for hours at a time. All right, guys, so another thing I like about Jeollado is, like this wind out here, my grandfather, he was harsh but real. So originally I was gonna go into this Kaldo island behind me. Freaking amazing! There's another big ass bridge back there, but it's so windy, I'm scared. Like, the little bit of hair is about to fly away right now. But yeah, definitely check it out! Alright guys, I'm back in Gangjin town. I'm super sorry about that, but this is the main point of the video, and I couldn't think properly with that terrifying real experience I was having out there fighting the wind. But here's where, when I say Jeollado is real, I think I have a little bit of a better understanding than maybe most foreigners about what that concept means, in that I know my grandfather. And yes, you know, it is sort of what you expect, in that he doesn't mince his words. He was very direct. But you can sort of see how people would appreciate how he wasn't two-faced about anything. If he didn't like you, you'd know. And if he liked you, you'd also know. But when I say Jeollado is real, I mean something a lot deeper than that. One way I could say Jeollado is real is the experiences, knowledge. When you ask for information, people will say, hey, you know, you could learn this in this class, or you can go to YouTube and figure it out with this video. But everything here is experienced and real. If you want to know how you could grow something, or how to catch a fish, or what kinds of plants you could harvest out of the mountains.
이 뻘에서 뭐 또 다른 거 먹을 수 있는 거 잡을 수 있어요?
꿀! 꿀따구!
굴도 여기서 찾을 수 있어요?
굴도 이렇게 다 굴이야. 이런 게 나오는 것이 다 붙은 것이.
These people have real experiences and real knowledge as to how to do that. And they're not gonna point you to some YouTube video or something they've heard from somebody else. Everything is experienced here and real. They're gonna tell you based on their experience. The experiences being real isn't just about knowledge. It even goes into the landscape and everything around you. Obviously, you're not in a city, so all the things around you, they're real, they're natural. The trees, the flowers, even the buildings. A lot of the buildings out here aren't necessarily recreations or something that was just brand new built just the other day, but they're real, authentic, old hanoks. I love the smell of these hanok buildings. I really don't think I can wrap up and describe in full detail exactly what I mean by Jeollado and how my grandfather was real. Because it's very complicated. But it's an area that just has me wanting to keep coming back. It pulls you in because every time I come here, I have these very real, authentic experiences. You know, although I pretty much prepared what I thought about Jeollado and my grandfather, even here in Gangjin, everything was as expected as far as the people. They're consistent. I can't even count how many conversations I've just had with random strangers these past 2 days here in Gangjin. They'll just strike up a conversation with you and ask you how you're doing and what you're doing with real, authentic, genuine interest. It's not like something that's fake that they're doing out of manners. So being in Jeollado, not only am I having real tangible experiences as far as the tourism experience, but you could really sense the real tangible feelings of the people that are out here. When they don't like you, you're gonna know for real. But more so than not, you're gonna have experiences of them giving you generosity, giving you real experiences of fondness and curiosity for your ideas and your thoughts and what you may be doing out here. And they will fully respect your individuality and your point of view. And this is something I just believe it's very unique to this region of Korea. I mean, historically, this region has been very liberal. And you know, when I say it's liberal, it might be misunderstood by a lot of Americans to be, oh, you know, they're gonna be a bunch of tree-hugging vegans. You know, they are tree-hugging, but they really love their Hanu beef out here, and they're gonna eat your octopus raw. But liberal in Korea is a bit different because it's not like America where the status quo was freedom, our forefathers forging the Declaration of Independence, etc. The status quo in Korea had been very Confucius, and even after the Korean War, it was under a military government. And that's what the conservatism is. So actually being liberal here is maybe closer to what American conservatism is, in that they want freedom. That's why back when there was a military government that was ruling Korea, Gwangju and Jeollado, they're the ones that got slaughtered for protesting and wanting freedoms. So there's that rebel, real streak that Jeollado has that I really like out here. There's just so many experiences I've had here, just as simple as just me being able to just fly a drone with nobody really saying anything or giving a damn, or me being able to just walk around and film people and ask them questions without them suspecting I have any ulterior motives. This is just how I feel here. I feel very comfortable in Jeollado.
This man is so nice. The shop owner is so nice. He's just like, you know, give him a tangerine. And then he wanted me to have his tangerine too. Now we're gonna have a tangerine here at this store. They're so generous here. I 맛있어요?
포장을 꽉꽉 잡혔잖아.
And it's just a very underrated area because it doesn't have like the same funding as, you know, Seoul where half of the people live, or even Gyeongsangdo where you have the second largest city, Busan, and a lot of the money that's been flowing in there. But Jeollado, guys, this is where it's at. This is the real Korea, I believe, that a lot of you guys have been seeking. But for now, I'm gonna go ahead and have some real authentic Jeollado cuisine. Alright guys, so what I'm having here is paechungtang. It literally means recovery dish. And it's a combination of seafood as well as chicken and eastern herbal medicines. And it's supposed to help you look younger. And they said maybe it'll help me grow back my hair.
Definitely not vegan.
Alright guys, so I want to summarize Jeollado food. I mean, obviously you can see that it's visually stunning, there's a lot of good ingredients, but the reason I like Jeollado food, it's very specific. Because Jeollado has been typically a farming agricultural area, they have an abundance of ingredients. Not only that, you would imagine they only have rice and lamb-based foods. Of course, their beef and everything is good, but Jeollado in the West Coast is also characterized by the mudflats, where you have like the octopuses and such that a lot of the seafood is based out of. So historically, it's been very rich in ingredients. And in that sense, the cuisine here is far more developed than any other area in Korea, in my opinion. And that is why Jeollado is very well recognized as one of the top premier cuisinal areas in Korea. And particularly for an American palate like me, I like it because unlike areas like Gyeongsangdo in the southeastern area where they stress a lot of the seafood taste, I don't really like fishy scents. So they use a lot of the spices here in order to camouflage that and make it like a very clean taste. So it's really hard to explain it, but I highly recommend that you come to Jeollado to taste the cuisine here. And when you do come to Gangjin, they are actually known for their hanjeongsik, which is like a combination dish which has a lot of different side dishes. I think because of that history and their ability to have a lot of different kinds of dishes and master that, literally every restaurant I've been here, their side dishes and every ingredient and thing they put out is one of the best I've ever had. So I highly recommend that you come out here to Gangjin in particular and try Jeollado dishes. It blew my mind. I mean, there's other like YouTube food bloggers and such that have come out here and they were blown away as well. And I'm not hyping it up. It's like every little thing I've had here, whether it be like a random small mom and pop regular lunch restaurant or something like this that's particularly special, it's been very, very unique and amazing. All right guys, so I just finished one of the most delicious meals I've ever had in my life. And that's saying a lot because I also had one of the most delicious meals I ever had in my life yesterday as well. And I'm honestly not ready to wrap up this story of my grandfather and Jeollado and Gangjin because there's just so much that still needed to be said. But I guess like my grandfather who recently passed away, without me also being able to say much to him and him everything he wanted to say to me, I guess I'll just have to wrap it up and hope you guys can come visit the real Korea, the real Jeollado, real Gangjin before it also disappears. This is something that I'll explain in my next vlog a little bit more, but you know, old towns, old streets like this, they're becoming a thing of the past because unfortunately, Koreans like things redeveloped, everything new. So they created like a new area of Gangjin, and there are areas like this that although it has appeal to someone like me that likes things authentic, real, doesn't really hold a lot of value to people who are young and starting a family, etc. They want the nice gentrified things. That's why I'm sort of appealing to you guys to also consider coming out to places like this and experience the true Korea. Because honestly, this is stuff that you guys are always complaining about, saying Korea is too superficial, Korea is too this. But this place, small little towns like Gangjin, it's everything that you probably wanted. And it's certainly what I look for when I travel. Whatever the case, I'll be coming back with one more video about Gangjin and some entrepreneurs I met here that are young and trying to revitalize old towns like this to see what made them come here to tell you their stories. So until that time, live, travel, Asia, guys. Bye-bye.